For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ArkIT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to learn about what is a web server and how we are going to install a web server in Linux and access this web server using the any client machine, whether you can use the Linux client machine or the Windows client machine, any client machine. So how this web servers works and what is this web server is all about.
Like, share, comment and subscribe.
So web server, in the sense, like most of the internet, if you say that internet, in the sense it's a web server. Okay, for example, say that if you are accessing any websites, any websites, like just like you are accessing the web server for reading some information or booking the bus tickets or flight tickets or whatever it is, looking into the some videos and all this stuff. So, which means that you are accessing some of the servers for your some purpose, right? So, how these web servers are served, or how you will get this example, say that if you go to the web page and type arkit.co.in, then you can see that the web page is loaded and you can see that information on that website. Okay, then how you are going to see that website, how it is going to be loaded, so what are the requests, where the request is going to be sent and all this stuff. Example, say if you go to that web page and type some google.com, then it goes to the DNS request. Example, say that from your machine, if you type that google.com, then what happens is that the DNS request from your machine to from your gateway, in the sense whatever the internet gateway you have, that gateway it will send to the DNS request. So the DNS request, what happens is that it resolves this DNS request. Example, say that if you type google.com, so it does not understand what does mean by the google.com, so it's sent to the DNS and DNS will resolve that google.com's IP address. Then the request will be sent to that public IP address, and the public IP may be NAT or internal to the local IP address. Then it hit to that web server, and the web server will send a name written reply to that client, and the gateway will carry that packet and again send it back to this your gateway, and you can see this page. Okay, so this is the process happens in between your web server and your client. So whenever you send any request, example, say I want this page, load it, then it sends the DNS request, and DNS request will resolve that IP address, the name, then it will send to that web server with that IP address, whatever the server is having that IP address. Then the web server will send the whatever the pages it has or whatever you have requested for. If you do not have any pages, it says that 404, in the sense there is no page available whatever you requested for from my site. Okay, that's how the web server can be accessed to the users. Okay, now we know that, okay, this is what how our request is going back to the server and accessing the system. Now we can go ahead and see that how to install this web server and configure this web server on the Linux machine on the RHCE 7 version, and we just host some static web page and access from the browser. Just I'm opening this server here and say m install httpd. So by default, httpd is the package you have to install to start the web services. Then after that, you have to enable this port numbers of this httpd. By default, the web server port number is 8. If you are using the SSL certificate, that is a 443. So the packages get installed over here. Now what we have to do, systemctl status and verify this httpd service is started. No, it's not started. We have to start this service. First of all, enable this service httpd, then start the service. It takes little bit of time because it has to verify status. Okay, now the web server is started successfully. After that, what you have to do here is that you have to go to firewall cmd command and add this --, add service equal to http, then reload this. Okay, by default you have installed and started the service and enable the port http port. So the default web hosted path or the default the hosting files path is that /var/www.html. So this is the path where the default web pages can be hosted, or the by default web root path, the document root path is over here. So here the by default the page name called index.php or index.html, whatever it is, you have to create that one. So I'm just creating index.html, and here I'm just making some HTML code over here, a simple code. What I'm making over here, it is that h1, okay, welcome to TechArkIT website, okay. And you have to close that h1 over here and close this html tag. It's simple, just I wanted to one line of my web server would be over here. Now my web server is ready with the default configuration. I'm not changing anything over here. I just wanted to run one default page, and the default page is going to be run over here. Okay, let's go ahead and see how we can do that. So first of all, you have to collect this IP address of your server which you have installed over here, because I'm not going to use any DNS configuration over here. That's why I just call directly an IP address of that web server. See this, welcome to TechArkIT website. That's it. So you are able to access your web server. If you stop the service and see that whether you are able to access that server, you cannot, right? Because the service is not serving the data, you cannot access any services. Now you just go to this page and refresh over here. See, it's gone. Again, start this back. Now go back over here and refresh. Now you can able to access the website. This is the simplest way you can start your website, okay, or the host your web server in your Linux machine, just installing the httpd services and using your default configuration files. So here I did not make any changes over here, just by the default configuration I made this web server available. So for more virtualized hosting and customizing the web server content and restricting some content, all the stuff we go ahead and see on the next upcoming classes. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses.